Good morning. This is your boy, the one and only J-Man. And you're listening to Coffee and Conversation on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do. We're going to have a great day today. I hope you all have a great and wonderful, blessed day today. I hope you all's night was easy, restful, and peaceful. Today is going to be even a better day for you. I guarantee something good is going to happen to you. Let me say hello to everyone that's in the house. We have a new voice in the house, Rachel. Nurse Rachel, and Nurse Yolanda are on. They are my nurses taking care of my girl Yogi up there at Emory Oncology. And I don't know them other words on there, but it's oncology, encology, pecology. You know, the big medical term word. Yeah. Nurse Rachel. Nurse, who else did I say? Yolanda. Nurse Yolanda, good morning to you. Dr. Tony is in the house. Good morning, Dr. Tony. Wanda, good morning to you, dear. Thank you so much for being in the room. Yogi, my girl, is in the room. Good to have you on the show, Yogi. Oh, we got a special guest today. He doesn't speak much, but he's here. Good morning to the fly that landed on Biden's head last. He's sitting over. I am going to try to get him to interview, if I can get him to interview in a few minutes. He's getting situated in. He said that he wanted to apologize to what happened yesterday, but you know how things go. You know how things go. The whole department is listening up there at Emory. Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning to all of you all up there. Emory Oncology, good morning to you. Philly is in the house. Philly, landed on Pence's head. I said Biden. He landed on Pence's head. He was talking. Let me stop. I got to behave today. Hey, this is the morning motivation. This morning's coffee and conversation. Oh, coffee and conversation. You're supposed to be there. You're supposed to have your coffee in hand and ready to get your day started. You're supposed to have your coffee in hand, ready to get your day started. Today, it simply started from the key phrase of that song I just played. I've got to get myself together because I got somewhere to go. I have to get myself together because I have somewhere to go. Look, let me tell you about life. Life, it's a funny little animal that loves, for the lack of a better word, no pun intended, it likes flying around us. It likes bringing itself to us. It likes throwing curveballs at us. It likes handing fastball, and then the next thing you know, it throws a changeup on it. But it's how we handle those problems and those things that life hands to us. It is those struggles that makes us stronger. I'll say that again. It is those struggles that makes us stronger. If you think about a bodybuilder only becomes stronger by adding more weight, by struggling. She goes to the gym, and when they get on the barbell, if they begin to notice that the things that they're lifting has become easier for them, what they do is start adding more weight. That is a good thing, ladies and gentlemen. Whenever you are struggling, understand that it is a good thing that you are struggling. I'll give you a perfect example. In our Christian walk, we oftentimes suggest that we're struggling with our demons, our enemies, the devil, for the lack of a better phrase. We say that we're struggling with the devil. That means, watch this, that means you are on the opposite end you're on the opposite end of the tug of war rope. You remember the game tug of war? In the game of tug of war, you literally feel yourself pulling against someone else or something or somebody else or other people. You had a team or a team on one side and there was another team on the other side and there was a struggle. You know that you are in the right place when you are struggling with the enemy. You know that you know because if you were never ever struggling, that means something is wrong. Something is wrong, and I just may be on the enemy side. So thank God that there is a struggle. Thank God that there is a something going on inside of your life. And you're trying to figure out, why am I going? Because God is trying to prove just how strong you are. And when you get to the place where you say, you know what, I'm going to embrace this struggle. In other words, I'm going to get into this fight. Are you willing to get into this fight? There's no need to sit back and watch the fight when you're in the ring. I'll say that again. There is no reason to watch the fight when you're already in the ring. Sometimes we have to learn to lace up our boots, put our gloves on, and put in the work. That's what they call it in the streets, if I'm not mistaken, Philly. Are you willing to put in the work to prove yourself? Are you willing to put in the work? Ladies and gentlemen, this fight, ladies and gentlemen, this struggle is not going to come to you easy. The win is not going to come to you easy. You're going to have to do your part. You're going to have to put in work. In the streets, when you, in order to be a part of the team, to be a part of the clique, you have to put in work. Yes, those that believe in our God, the Creator. Some call him, have different names for the Creator. But if you want to be on His side, you got to prove to Him you are willing to put in the work. Watch this. Since we got the church folks on, I'll talk to the church folks when the Bible tells us to put in work. The Bible did tell you to put in work. Faith without works is dead. We can sit there and believe all day what God is going to do, how God is going to handle it. You can believe all day. But unless you put in work, it won't happen. Put your faith where it needs to be. Put your hope where it needs to be. But get up off of your tail and do something about it. Do something about it. You're listening to Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Mad on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do.
It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die. 'Cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes it will. I go to the movie and I go downtown. Somebody keep telling me don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes it will. Then I go to my brother and I say, brother, help me please. But he winds up knocking me back down on my knees. Lord, there have been times that I thought I could last for long, but now I think I'm able to carry on. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes it will.
You're listening to Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do. It doesn't matter how long the battle has been on your doorstep. It doesn't matter how long you've been dealing with it. The only thing you have to believe is that a change is going to come. It's going to turn in your favor. It's going to happen for you. There was one scenario they asked, how long are you going to walk around this mountain? How long are you going to deal with this struggle? How long are you going to walk this path? Yes, it seemed like it's been forever. It seemed like it's taking forever. It seems like no matter what I try, no matter what I do, it keeps being there. A change is about to come. But you got to keep believing. Now is not the time to give up. Good morning, Jackie. Good morning, Gina. Now is not the time to give up. Now is not the time to stop believing. And definitely, now is not the time to stop fighting. Now is not the time to keep fighting. Put on your gloves. Stand up straight, stand flat-footed, and let whatever is hindering, whatever is stopping, whatever is keeping you from being who you are supposed to be, whatever that, let them know that you, let it know, let the circumstance know, I'm still in the fight. I'm still in the fight. And if you get to a place where you can tell yourself that I got this. One thing I love about Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali would get into a fight and let people hit on him. Now, I don't think that was a soundest decision ever made, but before he even stepped in the ring, he would tell people what round he was going to knock them out. It's time to tell whatever that struggle is that you've been dealing with, I am about to knock you out. Remember the LL Cool J song? I'm about to knock you. Mama said, knock you out. Let whatever problem, whatever struggle that you're dealing with, let it know I'm about to knock you out. I'm about to win this fight. I am about to win this battle. I'm about to do whatever the beginning of this, the song we played earlier today. I got to get myself together because I got somewhere to go. Get your war clothes on. I think that's what y'all church folks say. But put your game face on. Like when Mike Tyson walks into the ring, he didn't go to the ring all dressed up in robes and things like that. He used to have a towel draped over his shoulders. Because he was letting the opponent know, I'm not here for games. I'm not here for show. This is all business to me. Y'all remember the fig tree that Jesus ended up cursing? It had leaves on it, but no fruit. In other words, it was all dressed up, but didn't have a purpose. Now is the time to stop being dressed up and talking a good game. Now is the time to be about it. Now is the time to be about it. Look at yourself. Look in the mirror. If you ain't got no mirror in front of you, when this is over with, turn your phone on. I know you got a phone in your hand. Turn your phone on the camera and you can look at yourself. And then look at that person in the camera and say, I got this. And let whatever struggle you're dealing with, whatever problem you're dealing with, I'm about to knock you out. Take your step forward. This is the moment that you take your step forward. This is the part of the, I don't know how many old school wrestling fans we had out there, have out there. But you remember, Hulk Hogan was known for this. Hulk Hogan was really known for this. Hulk Hogan would be down on the ground. And then all of a sudden, his opponent would come and hit him. And then all of a sudden, he'll straighten up. It's like it hit the enemy, his opponent hit him and he woke up. His opponent would hit him again and he got stronger. It was like every time the enemy struck him, he got stronger and stronger, and he woke himself up and he ended up defeating his opponent. Yeah, I know wrestling is what it is. Okay, some of y'all don't know who Hulk Hogan is. Let me bring it up today. You remember Black Panther in the movie Black Panther? His sister made him a suit, and the suit, watch this, was able to take the blows of whatever came at it. Watch this though, the blow. Yes, girl, don't make me cry like right now like that. Yes, Yogi. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. The bullets or whatever would come and strike him, the suit, and it made him stronger. Watch this. He was able to take the energy from what struck him and use it back against the enemy. Whatever striking you, whatever has struck you, use that energy, use that mindset, use that power and strike back at the enemy. I dare you to do it. I dare you to stand flat-footed and fight back. You got this. If you still have breath in your body, that means you still have a way to fight. We're praying for so many different people. We're praying for Aries as their family is dealing with the loss of her dad. Life After the Collar will be sending flowers. We're praying for Yogi as she's dealing with as she is fighting, as she's winning the fight over cancer. We're actually praying for all of those, not just Yogi, but those that's even in the same uterus, those nurses that's listening in. Let me see if I can grab those names again. Rachel, I think that was Yolanda, and all the other people that are listening in, and all of the nurses that are helping them. I am praying over your hands this morning. I'm praying over your minds that God give you the words to say to the patients. I'm praying that God give you your eyes that when you look at patients, you're going to look at patients and give them strength. I'm praying that God use your hands that even when you touch them, they feel God's presence in your hands. To all of the patients that are listening, to Yogi, look, y'all got this. All of a sudden, they're going to ask, how did y'all get better? How did y'all get healed? How did things get more? You all are going to become the example. Yogi is already the example for down there at the unit that she goes to. She's a lighthouse. We're praying for the young lady last night that was on Life After the Collar last night show, who said she was ready to end her life. We're praying for those situations, those that are battling depression. Y'all got this. Y'all got this. I'm with you, Chuck. I'm with you. Win your battle. Last night we talked about standing on your elephant so that you can have a different vantage point. Today is going to be different. I was getting ready to say tomorrow is going to be different. But today is going to be different. I decree and declare. You know, y'all don't make me real preachy right now. I declare that today is going to be special. God is going to do whoever that is that's looking for. I know who it is now. That job that you really want, that's going to pay you more than you're even asking for. You're asking for a certain amount. They're going to pay you even more than that. Whoever that is that's looking for that job. You know what the job is. You see the job. You probably already applied for it. And it's paying, they're going to pay you more. They're going to pay you more. She said she was about to end her life. And then she clicked on Life After the Collar and changed her mind. Oh, my God. I appreciate you all so much. And I pray that whatever God has for you today, that you all, every last one, every last person that's listening, whether you're talking in the chat room or you're just listening by ear, that God is going to show you something special about you. He's going to show you just how special you are to him. Today, you are his favorite. How can I be his favorite when you got other people? God got enough favorites. He has enough love. He has enough blessing. He has enough miracles to make everybody feel special. To make everyone his favorite. God is about to make you his favorite. You might as well go ahead and say it. He's about to make me his favorite. God, Allah, however you want to call, whatever name you call him, your creator, is about to make you his favorite. Look, I appreciate me and the coffee, me and the fly. We're about to have breakfast together. Cause you know, he and I got jokes. Cause when he landed on Pence's head last night, I asked him if he just liked landing on, I'm sorry. My bad. You all have a great, 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 great day. Watch God do something special for you. I'll let your boy. It's all good. It's all gravy.
It's Nappy Hour. Hey, yo, Street. The Country Boys is back. It's 6 o'clock. It's time to have a good day.
I got up this morning, and I said I'm going to do something for the United Streets of America. So I got Nappy Roots in here. I got Big Al 360 in here. This is Greg Street Certified. And today, yeah, you're going to see another street boy playing piano.
I'm going to have a good day. And all my homies going to ride today. And all these mommies look fly today. And all we want to do is get by today. Hey, we're going to have a good day. And ain't nobody got to cry today. Because ain't nobody going to die today. You can save that trauma for another day. Hey, we're going to have a good day.
Hairline fresh, new cologne on. Feeling so good, change the color to my phone. Orange Kool-Aid go good with Patron. No, hell no, boy. It's still my ringtone, free car wash. Had to clean up the Dodge. Give back when I can, just playing my part. Church folks had a fish fry, mustard, hot salt, light bread, french fries. Love for the big guy, hit the park, blowing, showing off their hops. Nappy Roots on the radio, and you know it about last night they hit the big three. Bought some Air Force Ones, whole tall tees, man, I'm loving BG.
Still above ground, that's the reason I pray. Got my car cleaned up, now I'm ready to play. Make a call to the stick, say I'm headed that way. Heard my cousin cooking out, I gotta get me a plate. Got this new outfit, ain't even out in the state. So if I ain't speaking too soon, but this a hell of a day. And the sticky got me sitting in a hell of a place. Got my stunner shades on and a grin on my face. My new grill looks mean, but I swear I'm straight. And the hood showing love, so I'm A-OK.
Hey.
Exactly what the children say. Take the day off, hit the park and just hang. Barbecue, roll a few and put up the deuce. And if it's beef, put the piece down, throw up your deuce. It's time to change our ways so we can save the day. For the children's sake and make a better place to play. If it's all good, we got your coupe and grip your wood. And if you're riding dirty, light just flip and blow you. But do it real big, exactly like a player should. Enjoy your 24, do your thing and rip your hood. The world is all yours, but still we all grind. Forever in a day, the choice you make is really all fine.